Now we will discuss what is these different types of motion. The first one is translatory motion. This is one of the such type of motions which are possible for the rigid bodies. Let us take a solid object which is in the dimensions of square or rectangular, circular, whatever it may be. This is a rectangular type body which was placed at the top edge of an inclined plane. According to the introduction as was given for this lesson, rigid bodies are treated to be system of particles, not a point mass. It is a combination of n number of system of particles. Because of that, we can assume some particles which are regularly or randomly arranged within it. So this is a rigid body. This body was in rest until and unless an external force is applied on it. We are using Newtonian's mechanics to solve these problems in the rotatory motion and system of particles. Whenever the force is applied, the body is simply sliding on the inclined plane. This is the direction of sliding. The direction of sliding is always in the direction of the applied force. We know that. Whenever this particle is sliding on an inclined plane, the particles of this rigid body all are united in the same direction to move. Because the direction from one particle, another particle, another particle, another particle. So we can draw number of arrow marks from the different system of particles which are placed in the rigid body, but all particles are moving in the same direction according to the applied force direction. That means if the number of particles or system of particles in a rigid body are united to move in the same direction along with the body, that motion is called translatory motion. If the system of particles are united to move along the same direction, with respect to the direction of applied force. That motion is called translatory motion. So, if the system of particles are united to move along the same directions which are placed in a rigid body, with respect to the direction of applied force is called translatory motion. This is the possible motion for the rigid bodies. The example for the translatory motion are the bodies which are sliding on an inclined plane without deforming its shape or structure. So all sliding bodies on inclined plane are the best examples for the translatory motion.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.